And if there's still money, if they still need more funds, there is an unobligated allotment in the COMELEC budget of $10.4 billion. And if worse comes to worse, if they still need funds, we can access the contingent fund, which at the moment has a balance of $3.5 billion. So it's not true that there's no money for the DOL election, so plebiscite.
Okay, so you mentioned that the funds from the contingent fund from 2018 can be used to add
to the fund balance of there's a fund balance of $3.5 billion,
and the executive department can use the funds without any approval from Congress anymore for that.
No, that's with the approval of the president only, because that's already part of the General Appropriations Act last year.
Okay, so just to clarify, there is no problem with the funding for the plebiscite?
Absolutely none. It's all set. It's a go. And in fact, they have printed the ballots, right?
Okay, Congressman Ndaya has been continuously hitting you. He has sued you before the Supreme Court for the non-release of the fourth tranche of a pay hike for state workers, and he's also building up his case against your in-laws. How are you coping with this continuous attacks from the congressman?
Okay, let's put it this way: the Hamors are not my in-laws. Okay, my daughter is married to a Sika, not the Hamors.
Okay.
And there's no truth to the allegations. And if he has a case against the Hamors, he can file any case against the Hamors. And number two, the DBM does not get involved in the implementation of projects and the choosing of contractors. The implementation is done by DPWH or the line agencies, DepEd or DOH, and the choice of the contractors are done through an open competitive bidding. So if has a case against the Hamors, he's free to file a case.
On to other issues, Mr. Secretary, we do want to get your reaction to the 75 billion pesos that you added to the budget of the DPWH has been deleted. Your thoughts on that, sir?
Well, you know, this is my 10th budget, 5 under President Cory, 2 under President Estrada, and my 3rd time under President Duterte. As a matter of policy, we do not comment on what Congress does with the president's budget, because as you know, that they have the prerogative. Congress may adopt the president's budget in toto. They may amend it or they may mangle the budget, but that's up to them, right? And this budget, the 2019 budget, still has a long way to go. We have the General Appropriations Bill, and then it goes to the Senate. It could go through many iterations, mm-hmm. and then finally they approve it. There will be disagreeing provisions. It will go through the conference committee. So as a matter of policy, the Executive Department does not make comment on what Congress does with the budget. What we are concerned with is the enrolled copy of the bill, that one which is already ratified by both houses of Congress, the House and the Senate. Then we compare the enrolled copy with the president's budget. And that's where we do the statement of difference, compare the two line by line. And that will be the basis of the president's line item veto.
Okay, but the 75 billion pesos that may be taken out, how is that going to affect the government's infrastructure push?
Well, it's elementary. When you take away 75 billion of demand, aggregate demand, especially if this is infrastructure, it would have adverse consequences on employment and on income and on poverty. So this has implications on our ability to make up for past neglect in infrastructure. That's elementary.
Okay, with the 2019 budget yet to be passed, are there any other projects that are being hampered by its non-passage, and how are you managing?
No, as I said, Ron, we don't comment on what Congress is doing with mm-hmm. the budget. That is their prerogative, right? We just hope that they know the short-term and long-term consequences of their acts, right? But we don't, as a matter of policy, comment on what they're doing.
Okay, Budget Secretary Benjamin
Gilmour. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir, for talking.